Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to demonstrate some useful string methods in Python, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Alright, let's do this. In this video, I'm going to be explaining and demonstrating a few useful methods available to us for strings. Now let's create a variable called name for this example, and you can use your own name if you want. So we now have a variable called name. And for my first example, let's print the length of our name variable. So to do that, we can surround our name variable with the length method, and this will print and return how long the length of our string is. And for me, the length of my name variable is 3 for 3 characters. If I were to increase the size of my name, well then that's going to change to 8. So that is the length method, and I'm just going to turn this line into a comment, and let's move on. So next we have the find method. I just copy and pasted print name so I can reuse it. Name dot, and actually if you have IntelliSense set up, if you add dot after your variable, you'll get a suggestion, well a few suggestions of different methods and other features that you have access to. So let's find, which is, screw this, I'll just type find, then we can find the first index of where this character is. Let's say I would like to find where capital B is. Well, that is at index 0 because computers always start with 0. So this first character would be 0, then R would be 1, and then O would be 2 for this example. All right, so that is how to find a character within a string. Moving on. So let's capitalize our name, and I should probably make this lowercase. So name.capitalize, and this will make my name capitalized. But if there's any spaces and then additional words, it's not going to capitalize that, only the first letter in your string. Next we have upper. This will make your string all uppercase. Name, upper, and now it is uppercase. Guess what's next? Lower. Name dot lower. And I should probably make this capital again. And everything is lowercase. We're making some good progress today. Next we have isDigit. This will return true or false depending on if our string is a digit, which it's not. So this will print false. If I changed my string to a bunch of numbers like 1, 2, 3, then this will return true. Let's change that back and move on. Next we have isAlpha. Are these alphabetical characters? Oh, make sure you add the parentheses afterwards. My bad. False. Because we added a space within here. Now it's true. So you can use isAlpha to check to see if your string contains only letters, alphabetical letters. Next we have count. We can count how many characters are within our string. I would like to count how many O's are in here, and this should return 2. That's right. Okay, we're almost at the end. We can replace characters within our string. So we use the replace method, and we pass in two arguments, the character we would like to replace and the character we would like to replace our character with. I would like to change all O's to A's, and now my name is Brockhod. Oh, you guys are gonna like this next one. This isn't technically a method, but it's a really neat feature. So one thing that we can do that's available to us with Python is that we can display a string multiple times by multiplying that string by a given number. So let's say I would like to display my name 3 times. I can just take my string variable, then add times 3, and this will print my name 3 times. Bro, bro, bro. Like I said, not technically a method, but it's a useful feature that you might be interested in that's related. Alright everybody, so that is a few useful methods available to us for strings. If you would like a copy of all this code, I will post this in the comment section down below. But yeah, those are a few useful methods available to us for strings. Hey you, Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learned something new, then help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.